this video addresses adding a reservation for a new customer or a one-time customer. Under the Booking and Logistics, you may select the Add New Customer Reservation. In the following window, select the appropriate type of reservation, whether it's a standard, arrival, or departure. Select the day of the reservation using the calendar, as well as the time of the reservation by using the drop-down options. There is no customer phone present because it is a new customer, but you may add one here by typing in. Enter the passenger name, greet sign alias if required, additional passengers, and total number of bags as well if required. Passenger cell is not required, but it is recommended. And passenger email. Ordered by, you may type in who is ordering the reservation and a phone number to contact in the case you should need any questions answered in regards to the reservation. Reference PO if necessary, as well as cost code. Booking source, trip category, booking category, and trip type all are selected from the drop-down list utilizing the list items which were entered under the list management section. They will be required in order to save the reservation if the settings in the company settings have been checked to require these options. Enter in any trip notes and preferences. These will show up on trip sheets as well as confirmations if selected to do so in the system settings, as well as any affiliate notes if you intend on farming the reservation out to another company. Since no address is present for the customer yet, you cannot select from the existing addresses. However, you may still select from the existing venues by using the drop-down options. If there are any interim stops, you may enter them by using the Add Stop and typing in the information if it is just a new address, or if it is one of the existing venues, utilize the drop-down list accordingly. Select the payment terms, collect, billing, prepaid, or process, the type of payment. No credit card is present, again, as it is a new customer, but you may add a new card by selecting the new card, enter in the information, and it will be saved to the customer profile, which will be saved immediately upon saving the reservation. You may also do a pre-authorization by selecting the authorization and utilizing that card as saved. Select the pricing plan from the available lists, the vehicle type from the available vehicle types. If it is a point-to-point or zone-to-zone, select the appropriate zone or pricing plan. You may adjust the rates accordingly below in the fixed rates as well as variable rates. Upon pricing out the reservation, if you're going to farm it to another company, you may enter the affiliate cost as well as assign it to an affiliate. There are no agents associated with the customer because it is a new customer. Prior to saving the reservation, you will need to enter a little bit of information which will then create a customer profile for later usage should this customer ever contact you again. In this section, you're required to enter first name, last name, phone number, an address which includes a city, state, and zip code or postal code. Once you have entered all that information, a profile will be created for this customer for later usage. From here, you may save this as a quotation, which may later be turned into a reservation by opening the quotation up and selecting the option to save as reservation. If you are done, you may click the OK button or cancel if you wish to cancel saving the reservation. If there is another segment involved with this reservation, select the Book Next segment, and it will automatically save this reservation and open another one for you to put the return or additional reservation in. If you wish to post a deposit immediately upon saving the reservation, select the option to add new deposit on save, click OK, and you will be presented with a window where you may post a deposit. Remember, this is how you create a reservation for a new customer which does not already exist within your customer database.